Hey guys, Elder Robert here. We're jumping in playing some F1 Manager once again. Let's hope that we can find our feet a bit. We're heading towards the Australian Grand Prix this week. We've had two bad weeks and we haven't scored any points. We're going to try a few different things this week and hopefully turn this around. All right, we're gonna get the team to start developing a new front wing. We're basically aiming for a massive overall improvement if they can do it, which should help us in cornering and also dirty air corner. With this new upgrade, we're going to try and optimize the aerodynamic. It is going to hinder us in brake cooling, but it's a necessary evil, I think, because we need to be getting more speed. And all right, and we're going to put 5 of our available engineers on the case. This is a expensive upgrade, to say the least. Let's hope that it is going to make a difference in the coming weeks when it's complete. We're also going to ask him to develop a new suspension. It's the one that we tested out last week on Lando's car. It was really good. So we're going to get one more as a spare. And if, of course, we do need to replace it, fall back to the previous. We've still got 4 of them in our inventory. All right, it's Australia. Let's do this. So qualifying target, we've got to reach Q3. Race target, we're trying to get the fastest lap. Okay. Right. Okay, and we're going to simulate all sessions of practice again. Let's see how confident the drivers are feeling in the cars this week. Okay, 12 and 13. So you've had some good run-ins, 30 laps each. Confidence is high, 69 and 59%. Okay, I'm comfortable with that. All right, and we're gonna manually manage them in we're gonna simulate the first round of qualifying. All right, Daniel got eliminated. Lando's in 12th. Simulate the second session. Can Lando get into Q3? If he gets into Q3, then we'll take charge. Oh, no, he didn't. He got 12th. Okay, so Lando's in 12th. Danny is 16th. Okay, so for Danny's car, we're going to start on the hards and go to softs at the end of the race. And Lando's car, we're going to do the same strategy. We're going to start on the hards and go to the softs. And what I'm actually going to do this week is I'm actually going to follow the strategies rather than making my own mind up, and we'll see how this goes. Because we need a solid week this week. Oh, not good. Lando has dropped down into 14th already. I mean, we have put him out on hards though. We're playing maybe the right strategy, maybe not. We'll find out. We're going to let him know that he can use his ARS for overtaking though. Same with Daniel. If they want to overtake, they can do. It's the start of the race, so they need to be trying to get some positions whilst the grid is quite packed. And we're also going to put them both on an aggressive strategy initially. See what they can do on these hards. Come on. Get the position. There. Oh, keep it. There we go. Nicely done. All right, DRS is in. Great move by Ricciardo. Up the inside. Love it. Nearly pushed him off track, but it's a good move. All right, Norris has overtaken Schumacher. Oh, it's just miles faster in the straight there. Nicely done. Nicely done indeed. Come on, Norris. I've got to be careful because they're both on aggressive strategy. So I do have to be careful. All right, come on. Pure pace on the DRS. Come on. You can get another one here. Come on, Lando. Make the move. I love this camera. This onboard camera is absolutely... Oh, just shut you off there. Nearly took you out as well. This is the problem. He's got bunched up behind 3 of them now. Not great. Not great at all. He's also on the hards, isn't he? So he's not really got the pace to take them. We're just going to have to hope he can get a move into a corner where they're feeling sloppy. Danny is right behind someone there. I think that is Alex. Right behind that. Albon, I think. Yeah, he is. All right, he's right behind Albon. Div can take. Come on, Danny. Oh, he might go for it to the next corner. Next big corner, anyway. Go around the outside. Is he going to make it stick? Oh, onto the grass. I think he's made it stick, though. He has done. Well played. All right, he's a good way off Magnussen now, so we'll rejoin him soon. How's Norris doing? Norris is making places up. He's on Gasly. Come on, Norris. P10 now into the points. What can you do? So how did he take them all? Oh, he did it on the straight. Yo, he took all 3 of them at once. Ooh, cut that corner though. It let me get away with it. We'll take it. It did look like he cut the corner though. All right, he's got 1.4 to make up to Gasly. Let's see if he can do it. It's a good stint so far for them. Good stint indeed. Fuel-wise, they're both looking absolutely delightful. We're good on pace too at the moment. We probably could do with harvesting the batteries really, and then we can use them, but I quite like the pace we're on at the moment. All right, looks like Danny's gonna keep going for Albon again, so let's see if he can make the move. Pit window, we're looking at 25 laps. This is lap 5, so we've got a good way to go. Danny on the outside of Albon again. Oh, I think he's done it again. He just made that stick. This is a great battle. Great job. Great job indeed. All right, see, the problem is now he's gonna defend that. Albon's gonna get I don't think he had DRS on the first corner. He will on the next one. All that's gonna happen is he will He'll peak losing that position back. We've got to be really careful. Oh no, Ocon's overtook Norris. What did he do? Oh, on the straight. On the straight. No proper defense there. That's the problem because we're not harvesting the battery. We are just going to get him to harvest the battery a little bit. Let's just get the batteries full and then we can use them for something. Because it also benefit Daniel because he can use it for defense on Albon. I love the fact this has got the real, like, real drivers team commentary. It's class that. Oh, Albon's took him again. Oh, Danny on the defense. Can he keep him off? Oh, that was... This is absolutely amazing battles going on here. Absolutely amazing battling going on. I love it. But you love to see. Right, we are going to go and see how Norris is doing. He's caught up Gasly. And I'm going to presume everyone is Ocon, maybe? What can they do? All right, it's three abreast again. Yeah, we lost a position there. But we're going to get our ERS back. And we've got to remember we are on hards. Our strategy is to have pace at the end of the race, not the start of the race. So the start of the race is just about not losing too many positions. You can totally take them again, though. You can totally take them again. All right, he's got DRS down straight. Can he do it? Can he do it? Oh, no, but he has closed up. All right, he's got his DRS back. We're going to let him know that he can use it for overtake. And Daniels, we're going to have to tell him he can use it for defense because he's got Vettel right behind him. But we need him to be making plays. Up. If anything, he's got clear air right now. Let's send him on his way. Let's try and get a position. Got a little time on these hards left. This is usually where I start making mistakes because I'm now deciding I've got too much control over strategy. But yeah, hopefully this pays off. Come on, Norris. Come on. You've got plus 5 laps as well. You can push it. All right, attack him. Attack him, and you've got overtake. Right, he's gonna get DRS down here. He's gonna take both of them. Into the first corner. Very nicely done. Very nicely done indeed. Right, chased out Alonso now. Danny's battery is drained. He has managed to do what we wanted him to, though. Make some positions. Make some time up. That is good. Norris is going to have to harvest again. But ideally, we want him to actually be using it for defense. So we're going to keep him on this aggressive strategy. Like attack strategy though, because if we can get these timings down, he's in a much better position. Just got Ocon all over him. Yeah, that's the problem. Ocon is just right there every time. Every time. Come on, Lando, you need to get him positions back. Come on. All right, you got DRS on him. DRS into first corner. Oh, nope. Couldn't make it. That is a nice move. Can you make it stick though? That's the problem. Nah. Just our track position every corner. Come on, Lando. Keep the position. All right. Nicely done. Problem is he's going to have DRS on us. So he might take this straight back. Yeah, he has. Just not got enough cushion. We're having to use the DRS to overtake him, but then we can't defend quick enough. All right, people are starting to pit. Our pit window is only in 15 more laps. So those coming in now are potentially on a 2-stop. It means we really need to push whilst everyone's coming in. Try and get as much clean space on the track as we can. Make the most of the rest of this hard tire. Come on, Lando, make it stick. Woo, just about. All right, Ricardo's caught up with all the noise. Everyone has come out of the pit stops. They're going to have fresh tires. What can he do? Some good battling here. Oh, he's got DRS, but still not be able to make position. Come on. Nice. You might lose that, though. It's a very nice move. Very nice move indeed. Fantastic work from Danny here, though, to make these positions up. Oh, he's going to get him. He's got him. Got him into the first corner. Very nicely done indeed. Very nicely done. All right, he's got 11 more laps on these. Can he catch Russell? Can he make the move on Russell? Time will tell. He's certainly chasing him down. These hards are actually performing really well for us right now. I know everyone else is coming for the first stop, so it's not kind of true as it could be. We have got two of the oldest sets of tyres on track there. Both drivers are chasing down someone that's already pitted, so it's kind of understandable that we're struggling a little bit, but we're going for a 2-stop strategy. It looks like everyone else is we're going for a 1-stop strategy, sorry. Everyone else looks like they're going for a 2, so it could pay off by the end, but we will see. Come on, Danny. Take Bottas. Come on, Bottas. First corner, get him. Oh, it was close. He might go for a move on further on in the lap here. He has really got the pace. Oh, Vettel has come in for his pit stop. Right, you have DRS down here. Surely you've won. Yeah, come on, get Bottas. Come on. Just can't get past him. Letting him do everything as well. He's got his foot to the floor. He's not getting any battery, that's the problem. But if I get him harvesting his battery, then Tsunoda's going to come back up on us because of the difference we've got on the track right now. Lando, I just kind of need him to be making up as much time as he can. Although I do want to kind of, how many laps we got? 7. I do kind of want to make sure that the fully fully charged when they come out on softs. So we're going to get Lando actually just to calm down ever so slightly, start harvesting his battery. And oh, looking at Danny, because of pit stops and stuff, he's actually got a window behind him. So we're not going to worry too much about someone taking him at the moment. Norris has loads of clean air up here. He's just flying, having a whale of a time. All right, this should mean that he can harvest his battery on these laps. What's he got? He's got 6 laps left. Let's just tell him to just calm it down a sec. We want to make sure he's within that sweet window of laps. We don't want to have to bring him in on softs too early. All right, Danny is still sat behind these lot. He makes the move. He's got DRS. He's a long way off the pace. No, we're gonna keep harvesting. He's got 5 laps potentially when we'll bring him in. Try and bring him in the sweet spot of that blue section, which is kind of our pit window. The only problem is where these are gonna feed back out, because we've not been able to make up as much time as we'd have really liked. And the cars behind us are on fresher tires. So we do have to hope that everyone has gone 2-stop strategy and not gone for a short first stint and a long second stint. Come on, Danny, get Alonso. Come on. Come on, I have to pull you off the pace in a minute. All right, pit window is 4 laps. I mean, this is arguably the most relaxed I've been on strategy so far. Following the advice from our team back at base, which we don't normally, so normally a bit more chaotic. And I kind of feel like this might work out for us. We're obviously going to lose a lot of positions once we bring the guys in, but we've had a really good first stint, so to make this count, we're potentially going to get some points this week. But this is a tall order still, because after these pit stops, I believe both drivers, yeah, will be out of the points, so they will have to make some positions up. But coming out on the medium tires, see what we can do. Yeah, let's start bringing our drivers in. Okay, so the strategy was to put him on to mediums, which would get us 30 laps. Is what we're gonna do. Daniel's strategy is also mediums, and we ain't taking risks. It's all gonna be about where we feed back out. Let's hope we're gonna release them into some cleaner air. Whether we will or not, I do not know, but that is the hope. All right, Norris, come on. 2.6 seconds. Okay. Danny, we're at 2.5. We stacked our drivers. Put your foot down. Let's do this. Let's catch up to the packs. Good news is we have actually brought them out in a bit of quiet air, which is good. And get the tires on board. Putting some laps in some clear air. And then who knows what after that. We might make some points up here. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. If you can get both drivers into the points as well by the end of the race, that would be awesome. Certainly appease our shareholders, who aren't best pleased with me right now. All right. Well, what we tried to do has worked. We've managed to get Norris out. Fresh tires, putting his foot down, and he's catching up to the pack, which is what we wanted. So it's good news. We're going to get him to just chill a little bit on the fuel in a minute. We've got enough time to recover it. So we're going to see if we can, we're just a little bit more aggressive than we would have been. Try and get one of these down into the first corner. DRS should be enabled. Whether he can make the move stick or not. No, he's not going to make that stick. He's not going to make that stick. All right. We're getting one more lap, and then we're going to have to calm it down with the push laps. Come on, Norris. Ooh. So the problem is with this, they're both scrapping. You try and not get tangled up in that. That's half the problem. Right, DRS, come on, take the inside. Nah, it's not going for it. DRS is charging, though. He's harvesting it. So potentially put it onto overtake and get some positions in a minute. Come on, Norris. Come on. Not making the moves. All right, Danny, can you get Gasly? Come on. Inside. Norris made the move. I missed it flicking over, but he's made the move. We might get a replay. Will we get a replay? Come on, game. Yeah, there we go. All right, I do do it. DRS down the straight. Yeah, absolutely coasting past. Very nicely done. Very nicely done indeed. Come on, Norris. Oh, well, make it stick. Oh. All right, we're totally making use of DRS for overtakes. Come on. Let's get it back. Let's get that back. Problem, we got Ocon right behind us. We're not careful about this. Ocon's going to take 10th off us. Come on. Come on, Lando. Forced him out, but we got it. Oh no, he locked up. Oh wait. Oh, he locked up and went off. Oh no. No, wait, is he out? Oh, he's not out, but he has lost position. Oh, what a nightmare. Alright, we're gonna have to bring the pace down slightly on both drivers. Alright. Second round of pit stops. So there are some people that have gone for 2 stops. If we can keep these tires, and we're going to harvest the IRSs to defend towards the end, we could potentially do this. Come on. Everyone's in the pits. Let's hope we can make some positions. They're going to come out on fresher tires, though. That's half the problem. Ocon's come out and he is putting the laps in. He's took a second out of Danny just on that last lap there. We're going to have to be really careful here. Okay. Some others are coming out for the second stops. Whoa. Just got brake tested. All right. Norris is all over Bottas here. Got Better be careful though, because right now his tires aren't going to get us to the end of the race. Oh, he's took him with the DRS. What a move. What a move. I tell you what, our car, DRS on a straight. Outstanding it's been this week. Outstanding. Gav, watch out for Bottas coming back at him, but Norris is now chasing down Russell, which is fantastic news. Fantastic news indeed. Ah, he's locked up again. Oh, Lando. Lando. Just when his dad's going well, he locks up. What is he doing in that car today? Yeah, exactly. Ah. All right, come on. Don't think about it. Let's just push. You're both in a good position. We're going to get some points. That's all that matters today. Problem is, though, Norris is just messing his tyres up left, right, and centre. He's projected where might not get him to the end of the race. We're going to be so careful with this. Yeah, I am slightly worried for them tyres. Come on, 10 laps to go. Can we keep the guys in the points? Can we get our first points of the season? Come on, that's what we want. Come on. Lando's tyres I'm worried about the most. They've got 44% on them. We've massively asked him to back off as well because we're trying to nurse him up. We want the points at the end of the day. He's not got the pace to catch Bottas today, so we just want both cars home in one piece. No more lockups would be ideal, please. Slightly worried Danny's not going to make it to the end of the race on the tyres, but he has just lost a position, so we really need to try and get that back. Come on, Danny, we need you in the points. We need you in the points. All right, we're going to try and get the place back with Danny, but with Lando, we're just going to hold station. We just want to get him back there. Come on, 6 laps to go. Danny's got all his place to walk on if he's not careful here. He really needs to keep all that position. Come on, Danny. We need to get you up in positions, not lose another one. Not what we want to see today. Problem is, they're just so bunched up. Come on, Danny. Tires are on 30%. We're getting a warning. Potentially not going to make it to the end of the race if we keep him on that strategy. We don't want the tires to go away from him too much. Or else we're definitely not getting there. Come on, Danny, keep that position. Lando really needs to be careful as well. Oh, we've got 4 laps to go. Ah, story of our season. There's Lando's tires are going off at the end. We need the points. We're here for the points today, guys. As much as I want to come in and get fastest lap, we want the points. Come on, 5 laps to go. Come on, keep that position. Yeah, we're gonna have to risk it with Norris. We do not want to lose this position. No, we couldn't defend it. Oh no, come on Norris, a few laps left. What can you do? Both on full whack. They've got enough tire left to get there. 2 laps to go. Can we at least recover? I mean, Norris is gonna get points, but he's only if he doesn't lose another position. So ideally he needs to be in defend. Daniel, likewise, he needs to attack. We want to get 10 and 11. I mean, 10th either way, great. We're gonna get some points, but we've got to get them points. Come on, don't lock up again. If you have DRS on you here, you need to defend. Got no ERS to defend though. We might lose a position going into the first corner. This is gonna be so close. All right, we're a couple of laps down on what the race is as well, so we just need to bear that in mind. No, he's lost a position to Ocon. No. Oh, what a nightmare. We were so close to getting our first points of the season. And now, unless something disastrous happens, we're not getting them. Well, I actually really tried to be clever with the strategy today, but it's just not paid off. Not paid off at all. Well, 11th and 12th, I'll take that. But yeah, what a shame. What a shame. We were up in the points for a good amount of time. The strategy was working. We had 2 lockups. The tires went off sooner than we thought they would. And yeah, Ocon came and stole our points off us. what a shame. What a shame. It was a good race. Really good race. Guys finishing in 11th and 12th. As long as these tyres hold out anyway. That's the thing. That is the thing. He should do. Should be fine. Oh, Danny eyeing a move on Lando into the last few corners. Is he going to go for it? He might go for it. I've not put team orders in place. If he wants that position, he can take it. Oh. He thought about it. He did think about it. All right. 11th and 12th. You know what? I'll take that. Not bad. Not bad at all. The main thing is progression. We didn't finish at the back this week. Mid-table, just outside the points. Made improvements on the first 2 weeks, that's for sure. Exactly, we're building, Crofty, we're building. Yeah, you know what? 1 position made for Lando, 4 positions made for Daniel. Literally just outside the points. I'd say that's a success. I really would. Really would. Just like that, another week at McLaren is over. Still yet to score points. This is the closest we've come though. We almost did. But yeah, we're sitting in 7th in the table. No points so far versus Ferrari, who are on 113 after just 3 races. So yeah, we really need to step this up. The board has low confidence in us. And our season objective is to finish 4th or above. So we're already 19 points off that. But yeah, we're going to keep pushing next week and see what we can do. Until next time, keep an eye on the channel for more F1 Manager. I'll be back soon with more videos. See you in a bit.